that is this thing we have already seen in is first law of thermodynamics. So the first law of thermodynamics gives you the relation between delta U, then work done, and yes, the amount of heat which is added to the system. Now, what is change in internal energy? So the change in internal energy is equal to, yes, it is the difference between the amount of heat applied to the system and the work done. This equation can be written in the other form, that is Q is equal to delta U plus the work done. So this equation will tell you, yes, the amount of heat added to the system, then its internal energy increases by delta U and some amount of energy is used for work done. Or you can say some amount of internal energy is being lost for doing some work by the system on the environment. So this is nothing but change in internal energy. Now we have to see when this internal energy will become positive, when it will become negative, and when it will become zero. So we can represent it diagrammatically. So we have to draw some diagram, that is we have to draw the system. Now here, if you consider a system, so we will consider three cases. Okay, so here there are three systems. Now in this system there are some conditions. There are, let us see the first case, then we will see second and then third. Okay, now here if the work done, or you can see if the amount of heat is greater than the work done, then you can say that delta U will increase, that is delta U is greater than zero. At this point you will say that delta U is positive. Even you can see it is positive. Now here in this you can see that when this amount of heat which is added to the system is less than, if amount of heat added is less than the work done, that is the amount of work done by the system is more as compared to the amount of heat applied, then at that time you can see that delta U is going to decrease. Okay, and therefore in other words you can write delta U is less than zero. So here it will become negative. Okay, and here you can see that the work done is positive. Over here the work done is negative. Now in the third case, that is here amount of heat is added, work done, again amount of heat is added and work is going to be done. And at this point you can say that the work done is equal to the amount of heat. Or we can say, now if both the terms are constant, okay, if Q is equal to the work done, or in other words we can say that the amount of heat which is added, it is equal to the work done, or they both are at constant. At this point you can say that delta U is equal to constant, or delta U is equal to zero. So these are the three cases of change in internal energy. Now let us see about the variables, according to the variables, yes, we can explain the equilibrium position of the thermodynamic system. So thermodynamics variable and thermodynamic equation of state we can say. Okay, so what is variable of states? Variables of state and variable and equation of state. Okay. Equation of state. Now, variables of state means what? If any system and the environment are at equilibrium position. Equilibrium position means what? There is no transfer of heat. So at that point, that equilibrium state of the system can be explained by these variables only. If the two systems are not in variable, then you cannot explain, you cannot describe that system according to this variable. Now what are these variables? So variables are nothing but change in pressure, then volume, then you can say temperature, then mass of the gas, or you can say system. So these are the sub variables. According to this variables you can describe the state of that system. Now equation of state. Equation of state means what? It is a mathematical representation of the system which represents the state of that system. So for example we can take ideal gas equation. Ideal gas equation. Okay, for ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Over here N and R are constant. Okay, other terms they are going to vary, right? So therefore P, V and T, these are the variables which represents the state of the system. Okay, so this is the equation of state, and these are the variables which will help you to describe the equilibrium position of the two system. Now here, if these quantities are going to change, then the graph which represents the change in this, the equation of state, then we can say that it is graphical representation of these variables. So what is a graphical representation? So that graphical representation we will call it as PV diagram. Now PV diagram. PV diagram means what? It is the relation between that P and V. That is, one of the variable is going to change and what is the effect of that variable on the other. Now here I have drawn three diagrams over here. So in the first diagram, you can see here this shaded portion will be called it as work done. So here the pressure and volume. Volume is on x-axis and y-axis is all of pressure. Now since we know that this is the initial volume Vi and this is the final volume Vf. So here there are two volumes. And even here there are two pressures which will tell you. This higher point will have higher pressure and this lower point will have lower pressure. You can also let us say that this is V1 and this is V2. Even here also we will call it as V1 and V2. Or in this case I am going to change this. Now let us see, this is P and this is T. Now here you can see over here that this is P1 and this is P2. This can be changed. Now if I draw an arrow over here in this way, first of all you have to remember that when volume increases, or I will just draw an arrow, when volume increases, pressure will decrease. And vice versa, that is if pressure increase, volume get decrease. Now this arrow you have to remember. If this arrow is in downward direction, okay, that means what? The pressure is going to decrease x-axis. So on this x-axis, how we write the equation? How we write the numbers over here? This is 1, 2, 3 and it goes on increasing. Over here also it goes on increasing. Here the pressure was at higher point and then it started decreasing. Therefore, we can write your P1 and you will write your final pressure. It will be P2. Here it will be pressure. This is the final part. A point and B point we have to, yes, see. So, this is the pressure P2. So, what was the pressure, what was the volume at the first position? It was P1 and V1 and it is P2. At this point, here again, one thing you have to remember, if volume or here only I will write, if volume increases, pressure decreases and therefore this, there is a positive work done. Okay, now if volume decreases, yes, pressure increases and there is a negative work done. Okay, so here there is a negative work done. So you have to just remember, if volume is going to increase, then work is going to done by the system. And if volume is going to, yes, decrease, then work is going to never to be negative. So at this point, you can say that, yes, there is a positive work done. Okay, so this diagram explains you about the positive work done when pressure is going to change. Now in this diagram, you can see this is also a PV diagram. So in this diagram also you can see that here I have drawn a downward arrow and here I am going to draw a upward arrow. Okay, so upward arrow will tell you that this volume now it is going to decrease. So it is going from higher, coming from higher to towards the lower position. So therefore this will be one and this will be second. Okay, initial and final, because here you can see that pressure is going to increase. So therefore this will be P1 and this will be P2 because it is going to increase. So here volume is going to decrease. Negative work is going to be done. Negative work. By, yes, changing the pressure. Okay, now here also if you see that there is a constant pressure and due to this, yes, volume also remains constant. So at this position, if both are going to be constant, then the work is going to be zero. Okay.